Hello and welcome to another episode of Quick Bites. Do you remember playing games on the Commodore 64 that were just too hard to complete, or you were stuck on a level that made you want to break your joystick? Well, if you had access to a magazine like Zap 64, you could find answers to all your problems. So in this video, I'm going to show you two methods on how to make your 8-bit gaming a bit easier by using the poke command. When you load a game on the Commodore 64, you tell the CPU of the machine to read the game data from the tape drive directly into the memory chip of the Commodore 64. And if you take a closer look at how it is stored in the memory itself, you can see here that the memory consists only of two simple parts, an address and a value stored in that address. So the whole game would basically be stored in these addresses, and at a specific address there are instructions on whether or not to display a certain graphics, how many lives the player has, and well, just about every piece of information the game consists of to be able to run. Now let's take a look at how the poke command works. When you turn on your Commodore 64, it loads the operating system, and at a certain address in the memory, the background color of the operating system is stored. So we can change the background color by simply typing in the poke command, followed by the correct memory address, and then the new value, and voila, now we have a white background. So this is what the poke command does. Tells the CPU to change the value at a certain address in the memory. Now we have established how a game loads into the memory and how we can manipulate the data stored there. So let's try it on a game. The game Space Harrier was as much about dodging floating stones and trees as shooting enemies. As you can see, the Commodore version did not have the same smooth graphics as the arcade version of the game, so it made it a lot harder to avoid these obstacles and shoot enemies at the same time. But what if you could just get rid of the trees and stones altogether? Well, in Zap 64 issue 25, there was a little code function called poke that would actually let you do that. So let's run Space Harrier now by instructing the CPU to first load the game into memory by typing in the load command. Now, when the game has loaded into memory, that leaves us with the ability to use the poke command and actually manipulate the data in the memory. Let's try the poke commands we found in the magazine that would allow us to remove these trees and stones completely from the game. We'll change the value at address 128.11 to 0 to remove the trees, and then tell the CPU to change the value at address 127.21 to 0 to remove the floating stones. And then use the sys command to tell the CPU to start running the code at address 2128, and that restarts the game with the changes we just made. And now you can see that we can just focus on shooting the enemies with both the trees and stones removed completely from the game. So it's pretty simple and neat. Now this game, like many others, would not allow you to load the game into the memory and then issue a poke command before the game was running. Most games actually automatically ran when you typed in the load command. So the only way to get into the basic command was to soft reset the machine. Soft reset means that you would somehow need to reset the CPU to its starting position without clearing the memory chip. And since the Commodore 64 only had a power on and off button, that meant that if you turned it off, it would reset both the CPU and clear the memory chips that the game was loaded into. So to soft reset the machine, you would need to buy an external cartridge that would allow you to reset only the CPU to its starting state and drop you back into the command mode. And from here you could type in your poke commands. In the December issue of Zap 64 1987, I found this poke command that will give you infinite psych, or health. Here we are going to change the value at address 30242 to 173, and then tell the CPU to start again at a specific memory address with your altered code. And now, as you can see, our character no longer takes damages from enemies. Well, that's it for now. Hopefully you learned something new, or at least got a little perspective on why these old machines are so cool and fun to use. The question was asked by Hilmar, and I encourage you to comment on the video with questions like this one, and maybe someday it might end up here on YouTube. Also remember to subscribe for weekly retro gaming related videos here on this channel. Thank you and have an awesome weekend. Bye-bye.